वेरी ब्यूटीफुल गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ प्रोग्रेसिव लिटरेरी एंड कल्चरल सोसाइटी, आई डॉक्टर अनुपमा शर्मा वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑन आवर सोसाइटी प्लेटफॉर्म. टुडे वी ऑल कलेक्टेड टू डिस्कस अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट पैरालंपिक्स एंड सम पॉइंट्स रिलेटेड टू डिसेबिलिटी इन आवर पैरालंपिक्स. First of all, I would like to discuss about disability. Certainly, the success of Paralympians owes much more to a personal journey than a societal transformation. They enjoy a better social status, improved social security also. In addition to being a sporting role models, another important role for that Paralympians athletes as they are disabled, they represent certain disabilities, can use their profile for political activism also. In doing so, they can enhance societal change through continuing to highlight the ongoing inequalities. I just talking about inequalities. Paralympics have changed the position of disabled and also thinking of people about disabled, because they have done something which was not even thought by. Unbelievable. In spite of being they are disabilities in them, they changed our thinking of about disabled people also. Paralympic athletes demonstrate feats of superhuman strength, not just after an injury, but in spite of disability also. But alongside this celebration of exceptional ability, there must be a reflection on our worst disability. The way in which our societies observe the disabled people. Disability activists have long argued that individuals are disabled not by physical or intellectual impairments, but a society that does not accommodate these differences of disabled people. In other words, we can say that despite of removing disabling factors in some ways, that Paralympic Games can also undermine efforts to view disability as a societal rather than individual problem. Embracing a social theory of disability requires a large-scale rethinking of not just physically disability structures, but also of social spaces and workplace environments in order to challenge the assumptions that normal even exist they have to face. Further deconstructing the ways in which our society disables people does not end with buildings that have wheelchair access, but it can't least begin with recognition that Paralympians, like all Olympians, are exceptional athletes to whom the measure of normal can never be applied. So they can represent disability or a disabled people represents a different thing, a special thing in front of us in this Paralympics Games. Thank you, Dr. Shaminas, over to you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Anupama, for telling about disabled people. We see lots of disabled people around us, and we have sympathy towards them. We feel sympathetic. Some people also behave badly with them. But in the Paralympic Games, these people with certain inequalities, with certain physical weakness, have proved to be a motivation for so many. So now we have Dr. Kanupriya, who will tell us in detail about the history of Paralympic. Dr. Kanupriya, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Dr. Shaminas, and a very good evening to all of you. The word Paralympic derives from the Greek preposition para, beside or alongside, and the word Olympic. Its meaning is that Paralympic Olympics are the parallel games to the Olympics and illustrates how the two movements exist side by side. The Paralympics developed after Sir Ludwig Goodman organized a sports competition for Britishers, World War II veterans with spinal cord injuries in England in 1948. A follow-up competition took place in 1952 with athletes from the Netherlands joining the British competitors. The 9th International Stockman Derived Games, considered the first Paralympic Games, took place from 18 to 25 September 1960 in Rome, 6 days after the closing ceremony of the Olympic Games. Paralympic athletes compete in 6 different disability groups: amputee, cerebral palsy, visual impairment, spinal cord injuries, intellectual disability, and less austere, means athletes whose disability does not fit into one or the other categories, including dwarfism. India made its first Summer Paralympic debut in 1968 Games, competed again in 1972, and they were absent until 1984 Games. India's first medal in Paralympics came in 1972 Games, with Murlikant Petkar winning a gold medal in swimming. India's best finish in 2021 Games at 24th place with a medal haul of 19 medals, 5 gold, 8 silver and 6 bronze. It was a performance during which history was scripted almost every day, with the contingent living up to the spirit in motion motto of the Games. The Paralympians handed out life lessons on what it means to be fight the odds. It was a world scarred by COVID-19, yielded inspirations to fight on. It was in these times that the Tokyo Olympics Paralympics took place. The game truly lived up to an old marketing slogan, COVID, to promote the event. The Olympics is where heroes are made. The Paralympics is where heroes come.
Excellent observation, Dr. Kanupriya, and what a wonderful performance we had of the winner. We had indeed, as Dr. Kanupriya has said, that we have the heroes in Paralympics. Let me show you a video, if I am successful, regarding the Paralympic winner.
सुमित ने एक सड़क हादसे में अपना पैर गवा दिया था। प्रमोद बेहद कमजोर थे, उन्हें पोलियो ने जकड़ लिया था। अवनी की टूटी रीढ़ की हड्डी ने उन्हें खड़ा नहीं होने दिया, मगर इन जाबाज भारतीय खिलाड़ियों ने हार नहीं मानी। इन्होंने दिव्यांगता को कमजोरी नहीं बल्कि ताकत बनाया। परिणाम स्वरूप भारत ने पैरा ओलंपिक में इतिहास रचा। अब तक इस कांस्य पर और अपनी लेखना ने भारत को पहला स्वर्ण पदक दिलाया। 2012 में महज 12 साल की उम्र में अपनी एक दुर्घटना के चलते पैरालिसिस का शिकार हुई। रीढ़ की हड्डी ने भले उन्हें खड़ा नहीं होने दिया हो, लेकिन उनके हौसले कम नहीं हुए। उन्होंने पैरालंपिक्स में एक गोल्ड और कांस्य पदक जीता। वो दो पदक जीतने वाली भारतीय पहली महिला बनी। सुमित ने भारत को जैवलिन थ्रो में दूसरा गोल्ड जिताया। सुमित जब 7 साल के थे तब एयरपोर्ट में तैनात पिता राजकुमार की बीमारी से मौत हो गई थी। इतना दुख काफी नहीं था कि ट्यूशन लेकर बाइक से वापस आ रहे सुमित को कच्चे से भरी ट्रैक्टर ट्रॉली ने टक्कर मार दी और काफी दूर तक घसीटते ले गई। इस हादसे में सुमित को अपना पैर गंवाना पड़ा। हादसे के बावजूद सुमित नहीं टूटे और देश को गर्व के क्षण दिए। मनीष 50 मीटर पिस्टल शूटिंग इवेंट में देश के लिए 3रा गोल्ड लाए। मनीष के सामने दिव्यांगता की चुनौती थी मगर वो उन्हें एथलीट बनने के इरादे को खिला नहीं सकी। कई राष्ट्रीय अंतर्राष्ट्रीय प्रतिस्पर्धाओं में जीत हासिल कर चुके मनीष ने टोक्यो पैरालंपिक्स में गोल्ड जीतकर एक और मेडल अपने नाम किया। प्रमोद भगत ने बैडमिंटन में देश के लिए 4था गोल्ड जीता। प्रमोद जब 4 साल के थे तब पोलियो की वजह से उनका बायां पैर खराब हो गया था। उनकी बुआ ने उन्हें बड़ा किया। आज प्रमोद देश की शान है। देश को 5वां गोल्ड दिलाने वाले कृष्णा की कहानी भी प्रेरक है। तमाम कठिनाइयों को पार करते हुए कृष्णा ने बैडमिंटन में सिर्फ 22 साल की उम्र में देश का मान बढ़ाया। कृष्णा नागर को उनकी लंबाई के लिए लोग ताने देते थे। मेडल जीतने के बाद उन्होंने सभी को ये बता दिया कि ये गोल्ड मेडल उन तमाम लोगों को जवाब है जो उनकी दिव्यांगता के लिए उन्हें ताने देते थे। वहीं भाविना बेन पटेल टेबल टेनिस, निशात कुमार ऊंची कूद, देवेंद्र झांझरिया भाला फेंक, योगेश कथनिया चक्का पेंट, सिहराज आधान शूटिंग, मरियप्पन थांगुवेदो ऊंची कूद, प्रवीण कुमार ऊंची कूद और सुहास एल येतिराज बैडमिंटन ने सिल्वर मेडल जीतकर नाम कमाया। इसी क्रम में सुंदर सिंह गुज्जर भाला, सिहराज आधान शूटिंग, शरद कुमार ऊंची कूद, अग्नि लेखरा शूटिंग, हरविंदर सिंह तीरंदाजी और मनोज कुमार बैडमिंटन ने देश के लिए कांस्य पदक जीत कर लाए। देश को गौरव दिलाने वाले इन खिलाड़ियों पर न सिर्फ देश को गर्व है बल्कि खिलाड़ी लाखों करोड़ों भारतीयों के लिए इंस्पिरेशन भी है। टोक्यो पैरालंपिक्स ने हमें गर्व महसूस कराने के लिए थैंक यू हीरोज।
The team of Progressive Literary and Cultural Society also thanks Paralympic Olympic medal winner. As we have seen in the video, so let us discuss in detail about these Paralympic medal winner. Indian Paralympic winner earned a total of 19 medal in the recently completed Tokyo Paralympic. And this is, as Dr. Kanupriya has also mentioned, this is the best ever haul at the major event. It means 5 gold, 8 silver and 6 bronze medal overall. And last time when India participated in 2016, the number of contingent which India sent to the Paralympic Olympic was 19, and this time we received 19 medal by 54 athlete. The games, and this time there were some new games were also included, like badminton, and earlier there were many games were not included. So Avni Lakhera was the first medal winner from India on the first day itself. She was the lucky winner by winning gold. On the third day of Paralympic India's medal came from paddler Bhavani Ben Patel, who won silver in the women's single table tennis in 4 category. Like Dr. Kanupriya has mentioned, there are many categories. So different people compete in different territory. And Avni Lakhera had won gold in 10 meter air rifle shooting standing SH1 event. A few days later, she also won another medal, bronze in 15-meter rifle, being the third position holder. Furthermore, Sumit Antil broke numerous world records. Manish Narwal and Pramod Bhagat all took first place. Sumit Antil also won gold medal in javelin, in Olympic medal, in Summer Olympic game, we also won gold medal in javelin by Neeraj Chopra, and in this Paralympic also we won gold in javelin by Sumit Antil. Then Manish Narwal and Pramod Bhagat and Krishna Nagar, they all won gold medal on the last day प्रमोद भगत वन इन बैडमिंटन, मनीष नारवाल इन शूटिंग एंड कृष्णा नागर ऑल्सो वन इन बैडमिंटन. सो दिस वॉज अ मीन्स बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस बाय इंडिया एंड इन सो मेनी कंट्रीज इंडिया स्टूड 24th इन द मेडल टैली विद विच इज अ रिकॉर्ड एंड लाइक वी हैव डिस्कस अर्लियर सुमित अंटिल वर्ल्ड वन गोल्ड इन मेन जैवलिंग थ्रो इन F64 कैटेगरी प्रमोद भगत वन इन बैडमिंटन इन मेन सिंगर SL3 कैटेगरी देन कृष्णा नागर वन इन बैडमिंटन इन मेन सिंगल SH6 कैटेगरी मनीष नरवाल वन गोल्ड इन शूटिंग इन पिस्टल 50 मीटर पिस्टल SH1 कैटेगरी अवनी डकेरा इन शूटिंग एज वी आई हैव टोल्ड अर्लियर इन 10 मीटर एयर राइफल स्टैंडिंग देन देर वर 8 सिल्वर मेडल विनर योगेश खतूनिया वन सिल्वर मेडल मेन डिस्कस थ्रो इन F56 कैटेगरी नीरज निशांत कुमार वन इन मेन हाई जम्प इन T47 कैटेगरी देन वी हैड मरियप्पन थंगावेल्लू ही वन सिल्वर इन मेन हाई जम्प इन T63 कैटेगरी प्रवीण कुमार इन हाई जम्प इन T64 कैटेगरी देवेन झाजरिया हु इज हु अर्लियर वन गोल्ड इन 2016 पैरालिंपिक एंड ही इज ऑल्सो वर्ल्ड चैंपियन दिस टाइम ही वॉज अनलकी एंड ही वन सिल्वर देन सुहास यथिराज हु इज एन IAS ऑफिसर एंड DM ऑफ नोएडा ही वन सिल्वर इन बैडमिंटन मेन सिंगल SL4 कैटेगरी प्रवीण कुमार वन इन मेन हाई जम्प देन सिंहराज अधाना ही वन सिल्वर एज वेल एज ब्रॉन्ज ऑल्सो ही वन सिल्वर इन मिक्स 15 मीटर पिस्टल SH1 कैटेगरी देन भाविना पटेल वन सिल्वर मेडल इन टेबल टेनिस वुमेन सिंगल क्लास 4 कैटेगरी देन देर वेज 6 ब्रॉन्ज मेडल विनर हरविंदर सिंह वन ब्रॉन्ज मेडल इन आर्चरी मेन इंडिविजुअल रिकर्व ओपन शरद कुमार इन एथलेटिक इन हाई जम्प इन T63 कैटेगरी सुंदर सिंह गुर्जर इन जैवलिन इन F46 कैटेगरी देन मनोज सरकार इन बैडमिंटन इन SL3 कैटेगरी सिंहराज अदाना ही वन सेकेंड मेडल इन शूटिंग इन 10 मीटर एयर पिस्टल एंड देन द लास्ट अवनी लखेरा इन वुमेन 50 मीटर राइफल 3 इन SH1 कैटेगरी सो दीज मेडल विनर दीज गोल्ड सिल्वर और ब्रॉन्ज मेडल विनर हैव डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम इन देयर लाइफ लाइक देवेन झाझरिया ही his hand was crushed in the cutting machine and one of the athlete he met a severe accident that his he had to cut his leg so but these athletic through their willpower have proved that one can achieve anything if you are determined to achieve sometimes some calamity occurs or some thing happens and we lose morale our morale is down but at that time we have to think about these people who are fighting every day in their everyday life so and we can get inspiration to them and by and we ourselves have to be an inspiration to other no matter whatever odd and adverse situation we may face but the thing is that everything is short lived nothing lasts for long and we should think that this too shall pass away so keeping this in mind I thank all the Paralympic medal winner hope more and more medal come in Paralympic as well as Olympic category and more and more people are inspired by the deeds of these Paralympic medal winner not only for taking up sport but also in their life So now I request Prashant Kumar to please recite your poem.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for conceiving this beautiful program and honoring Paralympic winners and the powerful togetherness. This is a British poem, I feel. and this is for those who belittle differently abled people. And the battle. Blind, limping, deaf, you idiot. What? How could you read? How could you walk? How could you hear? Okay, I know you wear the caliper and sit on wheelchairs to move around. And you wear that hearing aid to hear silent music. And you read braille with your tips. Now don't behave as if you are weak and disabled. Hey, I may sound to be harsh, but yes, my voice rises against those who belittle differently able bodies with their qualified remarks, unqualified remarks. Now the so-called God has scheduled those of lives yes, are extraordinary. They are not, yes. Not they are below ordinary. The one who possesses all the limbs and sensory organs in order sometimes can't be competed to win, even being able-bodied. Yes, I have no pity for the persons with disabilities, for I behave with them as normal. For me, they are like any other. I raise my voice for their rights, for we are all together in the battle to endure and win the medal of Olympian Theater of Life. Olympian Theater of Life. So, this is for those who belittle differently, persons. So, this is my poem. It's a protection. Shall I go ahead with my another poem?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This poem talks about the perseverance of a lady who won the battle despite having the limbs. The title of my poem is Weakness. Her strength is her weakness. She stumbled upon the unpleasant with her courage. She tried to soaring peaks without realizing the gravel on the path of the course. She has no legs to make a peace with the rest of populace, but yes, this poses to be no deterrence. She is a fierce woman of heart. Nothing came in her way to act as a hindrance. As she determined to etch in times her name with golden letters, she lunged her head to grab the baton and fix the flagpost to the precipice. Yes, her strength is her weakness. Gosh, she scripted the story of perseverance to inspire many with no limbs. To inspire many with no limbs. So that talks about perseverance of the differently able.
Thank you so much, sir. A little more information I want to give you regarding this Paralympic medal winner. As we have seen, Avni Lakhera, the 19-year-old girl, was made history by being the first Indian woman to win a Paralympic gold medal. Then Sumit Antil broke numerous world records en route to winning the gold medal in the men javelin throw, with a best throw of 68.85 meter in the final. He is one of the greatest Indian Paralympic winner of all time. At the Osaka shooting range, Indian shooter Manish Narwal won gold in the P4 mixed 50-meter pistol SH1 final. He is also a 19-year-old boy. He had set a Paralympic record by scoring 218.2 points. to win the gold medal. Sergey Malchev of the Russian Paralympic Committee won the bronze medal. Then Pramod Bhagat, an Indian shuttler, contributed India's medal haul by capturing gold in the men's single event. He won the final by defeating Daniel Bethel of the United Kingdom. He was also India's first ever Paralympic medal in badminton, because earlier badminton were not included in Paralympic. Then Krishna Nagar, who won gold in badminton men's single, he defeated Shu Man Kai of Hong Kong in the final. Nishad Kumar, the silver medal winner in high jump, he established a personal best and an Asian record. So Nishad Kumar is an Asian record holder. He won his silver. Roderick Townshend Robert of the United States won gold with a world record setting leap of 2.15 meter. While Bhavani Bain Patel, as the name suggests, she is from Gujarat. She won the silver medal on the third day of Paralympic, sending a crusade of joy across the country. She defeated Chinese Zhu Ying. And then we have Yogesh Khatunia, who also won silver medal in discus throw with a best throw of 44.38 meter in the final. Khatunia was only beaten by Batista dos Santos Claudinete of Brazil, who won the gold medal. Then Praveen Kumar, who won silver medal in high jump in the final. He is an 18-year-old boy and he has also established a new Asian record in his weight by giving a medal to India. Then Suhas Yathiraj, as we all know that he is IAS officer and a DM of Noida. He is an Indian para shuttler who won silver at the Tokyo Paralympic game. He was just defeated in the final by Lucas Mansour of France. He's a 30-year-old bureaucrat who is also the first Indian administrating service officer to earn a medal in the Paralympics. So even the IAS officer can also win medal, he has proved. Then Deven Jhajaria, who won the silver medal in the men javelin throw with a throw of 64.35 meter, while Sundar Sir Gujjar of India won the bronze medal with a throw of 64.01. Devendra added a silver medal to his gold medal from the Paralympic. Earlier, he has won a gold medal. Then Singh Raj Athana, who is a 39-year-old, he is a polio survivor who has competed in the first Olympic. He fired a total of 216.8 to finish third after qualifying for the 8th men final as the 6th best shooter. He added a second medal to his collection a few days later at the Osaka shooting range. He won gold. Earlier, he has also won gold and silver in the P4 mixed 50 meter pistol SNWATH. And in Tokyo Paralympic, he won 2 medals. Then Mariappan Thangavellu, who in the high jump event, India's talent Mariappan Thangavellu and Charat Kumar, both these two athletes took silver and bronze respectively in the final. Mariappan won silver after clearing the 1.86 meter barrier. This is his second Olympic medal after winning gold in Rio. So Deven Jhajaria and Mariappan have won silver in this Tokyo Olympic. Earlier in 2016, they both won gold medal. Harvinder Singh, who won bronze in individual recurve open archery, he won India's first and so far only Paralympic archery medal, beating Kim Min-soo of Korea. Archery is also included in Paralympic for the first time. So I think sports are being included in the Paralympics, and we will gain more and more medal. Harvinder Singh, who is a 31-year-old, was ahead in the bronze medal playoff until unfortunately he lost. देन मनोज सरकार वन ब्रॉन्ज मेडल इन बैडमिंटन मेन सिंगल SL3 कैटेगरी. इन द फाइनल ही डिफीटेड डियासुको फुजीहारा ऑफ जापान. So these are the extraordinary tales of winning tale of our Paralympic winner, and hope we can get more and more Olympic winner and more people will be inspired by this. So now I request Shehnaz ma'am to share your views regarding Paralympic medal winner.
Thank you, Shehnaz. Thank you, Shehnaz, for giving me an opportunity to shower a few words of praise for these extraordinary winners. I hope I am visible and I am audible.
Yes, ma'am.
To all of you. Okay. Okay. So there will be certain repetitions in my presentation, but I think it will be worth it considering the achievement of these extraordinary players. Of course, Kanupriya has mentioned that Paralympics were first started in 1960 in Rome. They are also called Summer Games, Summer Olympics. And India joined in 1968. Tokyo 2020 was 16th Summer Paralympic hosted between 24th August to 5th September 2021. It was to be organized in 2020. It was to be organized in 2020, but it was organized in 2021. In Japan, in Olympic Stadium, 162 countries participated. From 22 sports, 539 events had been selected. And its signature sentence was united by emotions. This is also very important. Somaiti is the official mascot of the 2020 Summer Paralympics. It comes from two words. Somyoshino, which is a kind of cherry blossom, and the phrase so mighty. It represents the spirit of Paralympians who overcame all obstacles and set new goals with an optimistic approach. Now, with badminton, taekwondo, I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly, taekwondo was also introduced. Of course, China won maximum medals, 207, 96 gold, 60 silver, 51 bronze. China got maximum gold, silver, bronze medals. Then come UK with 124 and US with 104 medals. As far as India is concerned, we should look at this with a positive perspective. Prior to this, India has won only 12 medals since its first appearance in from 1968 to 2016. Out of 54 participants, 17 have won medals. India was at 24th position out of 162 nations. First time India won a medal in shooting, archery, TT and badminton. 3 out of 19 medals were won by women. 2 by Avani Lekhara. She is also the first Indian woman to win the gold. She is from Rajasthan, and one medal has been won by Bhavina Ben Patel. Praveen Kumar, who is 18 years old, is the youngest Indian to win a medal at Paralympics. Tej Chand, the javelin thrower, was also the flag bearer in the opening ceremony. Shooter Avani Lekhara was in the closing ceremony. Just in us a little bit of analysis. In 1972 we got one medal. In 84 we got four. In 2004 we got two. In 2012 we got one, and 2016 we got four. In 2021, 19 medals: 5 golds, 8 silver, 6 bronze. So earlier we had only 12 medals in total. This time 5 golds and India is on 24th position. So let's make an analysis of the factors which led to this meteoric rise in the number of medals this time. I must quote javelin thrower Sumit Antil, who says that his exposure was of the same level as that of Neeraj Chopra. In 2018, they both got a chance for training in Finland. And he also got a chance to compete in Italy, France, Tunisia. Yeah. This, he also says, is positive, and he says that it will help him in 2024 Paris Olympics too. So equal opportunity, equal chances were given to Sumit Antil, as he professes. Yogesh Khatunya also says that the government sees Paralympians at the same level as normal athletes in terms of awards and incentives. And not to mention, at Avani Lekhara's home, the sports ministry set a computerized digital target. Apart from, you know, taking care of her air rifle ammunition and accessories, Bhavina Patel got a robo as a practice partner during lockdown time. Now, Top SC is a target Olympic podium scheme. It is the flagship program of the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. It provides assistance to India's top athletes. Now, from 2018-19 to 2021-22, Indian government has spent 8.2 crores on Paralympians. Go Sports Foundation has also been of great help since 2008. Mention must be made of SAI campus in Gandhinagar and Table Tennis Center in Indore. In 2015, there were 700 para-athletes at the nationals. In 2019, there were 1,800. More avenues and incentives are being opened for the para-athletes to increase their participation. There's been a hard push by the government. Private players have helped them. Arenas have been provided and facilities have been geared up. The spirit that sings, same importance should be given to able-bodied and para-athletes has also helped. So, to conclude, I would say that for every sport or for every talent to prosper, a proper environment is absolutely necessary. And our Paralympians were fortunate enough to get this environment, and the result is clear before us. Thank you so much, Shamina. Over to you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think something more positive I can see is the enthusiasm of people and the highlight which social media is also giving to Paralympic. I think this is because of the success of recently concluded Olympic, where Neeraj, we have won more medal this time in Tokyo Olympic, and because of that Paralympic also was very much highlighted on social media. Every day we were getting so many news of Paralympic, and I see enthusiasm among people also. Like, India is a nation which mostly prefer cricket. This also, and we make heroes of cricket star only, but now recently Neeraj Chopra has become a star, and see the humbleness and simplicity the boy has. Means there is no attitude problem in Neeraj Chopra, and we means these people are real life hero, and the and by their becoming limelight, people are getting inspired, and because of the recent success in the Olympic, though we have won more medal in Paralympic, but I think that also inspired people, audience, to look up to Paralympic, and there was so much of enthusiasm when people were winning. There were lots of stories, and people were sharing about stories related with the Paralympian on their timeline every day. I think this also gave them inspiration, and I like this positive attitude growing among audience also, among Indians also, towards other sports, which I feel very disappointed when I see people loving only cricket in India. There are lots of sports, and we should love all the sport, and especially all those sports where our athletes are playing. So there are some positivity which has arisen after the these so many people have won medal in Olympic, and then I think the success of Para Olympic medal winner will pave the way for more and more encouragement, and people will more and more people will join sports, and even more and more audience will watch these sports and games. So now at the end of our event, I request Dr. Ruchi Malviya to please propose vote of thanks.
Very good evening, one and all. I, Dr. Ruchi Malviya, on behalf of PFCS, feel privileged to propose vote of thanks to all of you. First of all, I would just like to add a quick line which I have written, that everybody has his own lens to see life. Those who see it through the lens of pleasure call it treasure. Those who see it through the lens of despair call it a nightmare. So this is what I feel, that everybody has his own approach to life. If you look at that life with a positive attitude, you definitely see a beautiful, beautiful, colorful life. So this is what I can define the life. This is something that I can define the life of, or we all can define the life of Paralympians. Just don't bother about their restrictions, their limitations, their physical and psychological limitations. They just don't bother about it. Rather, they make themselves so strong. They are so strong in their willpower. So definitely we can say that where there is will, there is a way. So this year also, number of medals have been won by the Indian Paralympians. So this is really a very proud moment for all of us. We have to appreciate them, and we definitely have to appreciate them, and appreciate especially their effort, that how did they didn't think about their limitations, and they just won all those good laurels for our nation. I would just like to say thanks, words of thanks, to dear Anupama ma'am and Anupama ma'am, who very educatedly who just described the term Paralympic itself, and how what was the historical background.
I would just like to add one or two very important people. For example, I would
talk about Sima Selvai, we all really proud that we have seen him as a team of Allahabad also. Because for some time ago, and we have just watched his administrative service also. He contributed his administrative job here in Allahabad also. So it's a wonderful man. And not only you, but all other great people like Pramod Bhagwat, Krishna, Praveen, and Bhavna Ben Patel, and many others who brought more of our nation this year. I would like to congratulate them all. And last but not the least, I would just like to appreciate Dr. Saminas and all the members of this school, because this was really a wonderful idea to have a panel discussion on this subject, that is, medals and Paralympics, medal winners, the pride of India.
Thank you, everyone.